Mimir, did you know Garm? Why was he locked up to begin with?
Ah, Hell's feral sentinel. Well, believe it or not, Midgard was once bigger. Until Garm, then just a wee pup, got peckish.
He ate Midgard?
Only a few mountain ranges. And the fifth season that comes after winter but before spring. And a word for the feeling when you get so hungry, you stop being hungry.
You're messing with me.
I would never. Ah, another crystal. Best hold on to it until we can figure out what to do with it.
Kratos, off your back!
Roggerhole.
I see it.
I felt that one, brother.
You're on fire! But you probably already know that.
It's bad!
longer hold.
I see it.
Roger hold.
I see it.
Raised her dander up.
It does not matter.
Doesn't it?
If rage is all that remains, her reasons are irrelevant.
So, Mimir, how did they capture Garm in the first place?
That was Tyr's doing. He lured the beast somewhere safe and kept it distracted by lending his own arm to be gently chewed. Once the chains were on and the gate to Helheim was opened, Garm bit Tyr's arm clean off in retribution.
But Tyr's not missing an arm.
Well, it grew back, eventually. He is a very resourceful god, after all.
I wanted to tell you. I read something in Odin's library about what Gjallarhorn is supposed to do. If blown by a god, it sounds to all the realms and harmonizes the space between them. Blow it somewhere like Tyr's temple, and it would be like opening up all the realm travel towers at once.
It's quite a vulnerability. Wonder why he didn't just destroy it.
Some artifacts defy destruction.
Well, we should make Freya aware of this.
With that axe, if you tried. Done.
Hello, I've a task for you, actually.
Speak.
The tree has become rather overgrown.
And?
And if it grows too wildly, the branches risk getting too heavy and falling, which is not ideal considering they hold all the realms.
I am no gardener.
What an absolute shock. No, I do not require any horticultural skills from you, but I would ask that you keep an eye open for the stags of the four seasons. They normally graze upon the tree and keep it tidy. Unfortunately, Bitter decided it would be funny to trick Arrogant into releasing them. If you happen to find the stags during your travels, I would greatly appreciate assistance in bringing them home. I would have one of my spectral squirrels do it, but they, well, keep eating the feed I give them. Consequence of it being the most delicious food in all the nine realms, I suppose.
We have seen these stags.
Great! Then all you need is some feed. Once you've found a stag, the feed should calm them down. Then one of my spectrals will guide them back here. And, don't eat the feed, please.
I will not.
Bitterness asked me if I was too chicken to release them, but I am in fact not chicken-like whatsoever. So as you can see, I have no choice.
Yes, of course. What else could you have done? While normally this would be a harmless prank, Fimbulwinter prevented the stags from returning, and now they have long since scattered to parts unknown.
It was worth it.
Now then, any luck finding those lean worms?
As you ask.
They look quite healthy.
So were you always a freakishly large immortal squirrel, or...?
Don't Don't forget handsome. No, I was once a regular squirrel. The same size as these wispy, spectral versions of myself, in fact. I was unremarkable. I stumbled upon the tree near what should have been the end of my life, the victim of a random act of predatory savagery. But the tree, it had other plans for an insignificant creature like me. But I have prattled on for far too long. I will leave you be, Master Kratos. Well, I mustn't keep you further from your goings-on.
I was hoping we'd visit the crater again.
There's work to be done. Say the warriors still haunt the crater. We could put them to rest.
Also what? I strongly suspect there are more spirits who witnessed the clash that destroyed their home.
Let's do it. You can yell at me, if you want. We're leaving.
And what would that accomplish?
Might make you feel better.
No. You didn't trust me enough to talk through your worries. That's a wound not easily mended.
I'm sorry.
You needn't be. The fault is mine.
That's right. We got more food at home. Come on.
I have to say, quite a nice change of pace helping these stags get home. For a moment, I was worried we'd have to kill them.
Yes.
You had a plan to kill it if it had attacked.
Yes.
Thank you.
Come here. Not sure how to ask this. There are stories Odin told me, like how he lost his eye, where the details are different from stories you've told me. And I trust you, of course, but they don't seem like things he'd have a reason to lie about either.
One thing to remember about liars, lad. They lie. They do it on principle. No issue too big or too small. They lie about anything they can get away with and some things that they can't, just to demonstrate their power over reality. You must always bear that in mind.
Mimir, when I was in Asgard, I saw Odin do something to some new Einherjar. He seemed kind of mindless until he cast a spell that restored their identity.
Aye, that was his habit, even when they were confined to Valhalla. I think letting them remember themselves was another small way of cheating death any way he could. Though I wouldn't be surprised if with that small gift of autonomy, he also embeds an undying personal loyalty to himself.
The river's flooded. Do you think we can reach some new parts of the crater?
Unless my eyes deceive me, that seems to be the Stag of Summer.
Is it hot, or is it just my sizzling personality? Nah, it's you, Stag. Can we go already? Halfway there, by Septimus.
I do not like you.
I get that a lot.
Two down, halfway there.
Oh, guess what? While Odin was giving me a tour, his ravens took us to Svartalfheim, and I saw Derlin again. He was actually trying to do his job. We pretended not to recognize each other. At least I think he was pretending. Point is, it looked like Odin didn't know anything about Derlin helping us find Tyr.
My son, please, help reunite me with my son in Fulfanger.
We're gonna help him, right?
What is the last thing you saw, Spirit?
Statues. Two of them. Dragons facing away from each other. Separated like my sons. This toy. It will bring me back to him.
This story is like many in this valley. Separated from someone they love by death.
We gotta get him back to his son.
Agreed.
You do? Huh? I assumed you'd say something like, reuniting the dead is pointless.
Not this time.
If we keep going this way, I believe we'll reach that air dragon's lair.
Yes.
Just making sure you know where you're going.
Thank you.
Path's open. That dragon is shaking in its scaly boots, I suspect.
Once we approach the dragon, we will kill or be killed. Understood?
Yes, Father.
Oh! that frost in my neck, stump!
Say, that ogre's not getting up anytime soon either.
I can hear the animals. They're relieved. Maybe they'll come out of hiding. Elka!
Hunter lives here.
A careless one.
How's that?
We found its home.
Hey, Mimir.
Yes, lad?
You talk kind of funny.
Oh, how dare you, laddie.